Hello, I'm Rear Admiral Shardia Rojo, the Associate Commissioner for Minority Health and Director of FDA's Office of Minority Health and Health Equity. Welcome to the Health Equity Lecture Series. For today's lecture, we have invited Dr. Wei Sun to discuss health disparities impacting Asian American, Native Hawaiian, and Pacific Islander communities before and during the COVID-19 pandemic. Dr. Sun is an associate professor and associate dean for research and academic affairs at the Cathy Hughes School of Communications at Howard University. She is also a Fulbright specialist in communications and journalism and an elected first vice chair for the International and Intercultural Communication Division of the National Communication Association. She has taught various doctoral seminars and published on international and intercultural communication, community and public health, global health communication, race, culture, and social justice, and new media studies. Dr. Sun's most recent research has focused on COVID-19 health disparities. Dr. Sun, it's a pleasure to welcome you to the Health Equity Lecture Series. I'll turn it over to you.
Thank you, Admiral Orojo, for the introduction. Today, I'm going to talk about advancing health equity for Asian and Pacific Islanders communities. So here's a disclaimer and a funding statement you can read. On today's agenda, I'm going to introduce my background and Asian health disparities during the pandemic and the bridging gaps recruiting African and Asian American participants in clinical trials and creating culturally competent messages. My research specialties are in intercultural communication, new media study, and health communication. My interest to combine the three started in 2011, when I was writing an article about how Chinese cancer patients formed their own social support group on social media. Before I move on to the discussion, I want to introduce three important concepts. According to World Health Organization, health is a state of complete physical, mental, and social well-being, and not merely the absence of disease or infirmity. Health communication are actions to influence and empower individuals, populations, and communities to make healthier choices. Effective health communication is critical to health and well-being. Healthy People 2030 focuses on improving health communication so that people can easily understand and act on health information. According to CDC, health disparities are preventable differences in the burden of disease, injury, violence, or opportunities to achieve optimal health that are experienced by socially disadvantaged populations. And next, I'm going to discuss Asian health disparities during the pandemic. Health disparities are gaps in the quality of health and healthcare that mirror differences in socioeconomic status, racial and ethnic background, and education level. Nearly 17.3 million Asian Americans and Pacific Islanders reside in the United States, and about 64% of them are employed and have job-related health insurance coverage. 57% of Asians were born in a foreign country. CDC Foundation funded the research project Refocus Phase One. It was led by my coworker, Dr. Monica Ponder, assistant professor at Harvard University. I'm the senior investigator for this project. One area of the project examined five minority groups' social stigma during COVID-19. These five minority groups include African-American, Asian, Hispanic, undocumented immigrant, and LGBTQ communities. It has been well documented that Asian-Americans have experienced increased social stigmatization related to COVID-19. stigma has negative social and health impacts on minority communities, such as labeling, avoiding, shame, disgust, and social exclusion. The health impacts include both physical and mental illness and acceleration of health disparities. This study seeks to understand their life experiences and the subsequent coping strategies. The findings reveal that stigmatized behavior and the attitudes of others did not stop Asian Americans from following the COVID-19 related health guidelines because perceived health threats were high. Consumer behaviors of Asian Americans also changed dramatically towards buying almost everything online during the pandemic for the sake of the pandemic itself and the personal safety. This behavioral decisioning provides insights into the complex motivations for adopting health behaviors, and in this case, social distancing was preferred not only to avoid people, but also due to the fear of becoming victims of stigmatization in public areas. During the pandemic, historically underrepresented and ethnic minority communities have been disproportionately impacted by the COVID-19. According to an AAPI research in 2020, there is a 35 increase in death, or 13,620 more Asian Americans died during the first year of the pandemic compared to the previous 5 years average. According to CDC's statistics recently, Asian non-Hispanic COVID-19 cases, hospitalization, and death rates are 0.7 and 0.8 times more than white Americans. It is important to raise awareness, empower the AAPI community for reducing and closing the health disparity gap. Next, I'm going to discuss bridging gaps, recruiting African and Asian American participants in clinical trials and creating culturally competent messages. Bridging gaps, recruiting African and Asian American participants in clinical trials and creating culturally competent messages. This is an ongoing project in collaboration with FDA Office of Minority Health and Health Equity. The Harvard University team include myself, Dr. Monica Ponder, Dr. Shoa Almaki, and the two doctoral students, Brian Jenkins and Capriata Jenkins. And we collaborate with Communication and Culture Consulting, LLC. The team members include Dr. Donna O.T., Dr. Elena Lazarus, and Dr. Tracy Chong. The research background for this project is clinical trials with homogeneous participants limit researchers' ability to generalize findings to heterogeneous populations. Participants in clinical trials should be a reflection of the U.S. and individuals who may one day need to rely on these drugs, vaccines, or devices to manage chronic life-threatening illnesses. Throughout the COVID-19 pandemic, underserved populations such as racial and ethnic minorities were disproportionately impacted by illness, death, and devastation. Ensuring people from diverse backgrounds have the ability to participate in clinical trials is key to advancing health equity. The objective for Asian American clinical trials participation include investigate Asian American perceptions of clinical trials and the barriers to participation, and the test strategies to increase knowledge and encourage participation in clinical trials, and design effective communication messages to increase participation in clinical trials. And we have conducted 5 focus groups. And Asian Americans, there are 36 participants participated in five focus group study. The demographics of this group include 20 Asian women and 16 Asian men. And they are from 13 different Asian ethnic communities. The level of education, this group has a very high educational level. About 83% of participants have at least a college degree. The household income, at least 80% of them have 80,000 dollars household income. The primary fundings from the first five focus groups, number one is clinical trials knowledge. Participants in the five focus groups expressed having some familiarity with clinical trials. However, there are doubts about how medicine and the science work. For example, a young Asian man in his 20s heard about the clinical trials because he used to take care of his late grandfather. He said, the primary care provider suggested that if he wants, he could get into one of the trials, but it doesn't guarantee anything since, as she mentioned, it is a trial. It is not proven yet. So that was the first time I heard it. An Asian woman in her late 20s shared her concerns regarding clinical trials and questioned the risks associated with it. She said, to me, when I heard clinical trials, it is risky. To me, it is like it didn't pass FDA fully, and it is in the trial period. So I need to consent by agreement to get the trial, and then I take all the risk. Another participant believed clinical trials help the community at large, but because it is new, it could be risky to participate in a clinical trial. The second finding regarding clinical trials attitudes, participants displayed mixed feelings regarding perceived benefit, perceived barriers to all threats, and the misconception about COVID-19 clinical trials. Some participants presented anti-vaccines and anti-science attitude. Others expressed concerns related to racial disparities as obstacles for their hesitancy. For example, misconceptions and perceived threats. Participants showed concerns over the short time it took to develop the COVID-19 vaccine and the process of clinical trials. There was a clear lack of knowledge about clinical trials and what they entail. Motivators and the perceived benefit. For example, for some participants expressed the willingness to participate in clinical trials. Motivators included advice from credible sources, protecting elderly members of their families, and increasing their ethnic groups' representation in clinical trials. The third finding, perceived barriers and threats. The fear of side effect was the most prominent theme across all focus groups. Lack of knowledge has also played a role in what participants believe about clinical trials and the misconceptions they have about the process. For example, a married man said if he was still single, he would not hesitate to participate in a clinical trial, even knowing it is risky. But since he has family, he will put his family first before taking a potential risk of participating in a clinical trial. There are concerns about legal issues if the trial failed or privacy protection. Overall, the major observations include Asian population believed they are socially responsible and self-reliant. Messages that emphasize social responsibility and the ability to help others resonate. Perceptions of low impact on Asian American community conflict with the data. The best result of recruiting more Asian Americans participate in clinical trials could be received by targeting second and third generation of Asian Americans. And this group, the focus groups, have highly educated participants. For example, there is a physician spouse enrolled their children in COVID-19 vaccine trials. There are distinct differences between highly and less educated participants in terms of perceptions of Western medicine. And also, there are several scientists in focus group. They may have more information than the rest of the participant. So in conclusion, to advance health equity, it required the collective actions from individuals, community leaders, researchers, educators, medical professionals, and governmental agencies. The selective references are listed here.
Thank you so much, Dr. Sun, for that very informative presentation. And we have a couple pre-submitted questions that I want to spend some time talking about. The first question is, can you describe how information from the focus groups may be used to create key messages?
This is our second stage task. And as I said, this is a primary funding. We intend to recruit 25 Asian American participants to the study. And through the, for example, the major observation, we already had some idea that the credible information and come from the scientists or the national leader or the community leaders, they are very important for the Asian Americans to actually they will be encouraged to participate the clinical trials.
Great, thank you. And another question related to the focus groups, was there anything that surprised you from the focus group findings?
Yes, and when we know that the national data showed that Asian Americans, many of them died or have these positive cases and the hospitalization, the rate, but the home group said, okay, that has less impact on Asian American community and that they rely on themselves to keep all this information and protect themselves. So that's the part really surprised me.
Thank you, Dr. Sun. And another question that we received, do you think that the Asian community perspectives towards clinical trials may be different depending on the disease state? For example, for COVID clinical trials compared to diabetes clinical trials?
Yeah, I think because COVID-19 clinical trials, as some of the participants expressed, it is very new and the people are still suspecting the scientific, the process and if they are safe or not. So I think probably if it is a well-studied area like cancer or diabetes, when people are in need, they are more likely to participate.
Dr. Sun, thank you so much again for that very informative presentation on Asian American, Native Hawaiian, and Pacific Islander health disparities. We really appreciate your time today, and thank you everyone who joined us for the lecture series. Thank you.